We have seen many great rivalries in racing over the years, some more publicized than others. For example, Ford versus Ferrari is a great example. But in the Grand Tour, Jeremy Clarkson had mentioned that there was a racing rivalry in rallying which was far greater than the one in Le Mans, which was Audi versus Lancia in the 1980s in Group B Rally Championship. But I think that there's a rivalry much more fierce in WRC than Audi versus Lancia. Hello everyone and welcome back to the Drivers Hub and welcome to my studio setup, kind of, I don't know. So basically because of coronavirus or COVID-19, we cannot go out of our houses, and don't worry, I'm not out of my house, this is my parking. So this is just a place where I'm shooting videos from now on to entertain you guys and give you more education and keep on entertaining you in these gloomy times. Stay home, stay safe, be hygienic, don't go outside, don't touch other people, all of the formalities. Just be home and be safe, follow the government's rules. Four cylinders and four doors. Sounds like a pretty beige looking sedan, right? Well, you're absolutely wrong. The Mitsubishi Lancer Evo and Subaru Impreza are two cars which can go head to head with top tier supercars even today. Both of them have been dominating the streets for over 30 years, and we've seen the rivalry in video games, movies, TV shows and other places. But the origin of this insane rivalry doesn't start anywhere near to the street. It actually starts deep into the dirt. It was the 1990s and FIA had just cancelled the Group B rallying stages. And that is because basically Group B rallying was 700 horsepower fire-breathing supercars made for the dirt. And well, that ended with a lot of crashes, casualties and fatalities. So because of all of those complications, the FIA just cancelled Group B rallying. And because of that, many of the manufacturers changed their attention from Group B to Group A. And basically, Group A is a more sober and toned down version of Group B rallying, because most of the race cars based in Group A rallying are based off of production derived cars. So the rules of Group A rallying say that if you want to get a race car into Group A rallying, you have to make it off of a production vehicle and not homologation specials like Group B rallying championships. Most of the cars in Group A rallying have the same basic layout: four-wheel drive, a gigantic turbo and four cylinders. Toyota had the Celica GT4, Ford had the Escort RS Cosworth, Lancia had the Delta Integrale, and then there was Mitsubishi with the Lancer Evo and Subaru with the Impreza 555. In the Lancer Evo, Mitsubishi had made an absolutely legendary engine in the years to come, which is the 4G63T, which was a 2-liter turbocharged inline 4-cylinder block. In the Impreza, Subaru had also put a turbocharged 4-cylinder block, but it wasn't an inline, it was a boxer engine, which means instead of all of the cylinders being in a line, they were laid out flat. It was called the EJ25 or EJ207 in other countries. And this gave the Subaru a very distinct power delivery and noise. But as legendary as the cars were, the drivers were equally as legendary. For Subaru, it was Colin McRae, and from Mitsubishi, it was Tommi Mäkinen. Both drivers in their early careers were tossed around from company to company, and in some point in their amateur lives, both of them have driven Sierra Cosworths for Ford. But in 1993, the manager from ProDrive recognized Colin McRae's insane talent and skills in driving and immediately signed him to Subaru's team. It was not long after that Subaru found Colin McRae that Mitsubishi also found their hidden gem, which was Tommi Mäkinen, and they signed him to Mitsubishi in 1994.
First gear here for Mäkinen, slightly longer round the outside, that second gear probably. Now they look like the neck and neck, but McRae's about to go over a bridge as Tommi Mäkinen goes under the bridge.
Both drivers were rivals from their amateur careers, and this rivalry got shifted into their professional careers as well. And both of them had heated battles on the track as well as on the dirt for their WRC supremacy. But when it comes to drawing first blood, Colin McRae won his first driver's title championship in 1995 with Carlos Sainz from Ford coming in second. This was mainly because Toyota's gigantic racing team called Team TTE got disqualified in the 95 championship because of an illegal air restrictor that they had fitted to their GT4 race car. And because of that, basically, both the companies from Ford and Subaru got the lead and basically won. But all of this was going to change in 1996, because in 1996, Tommi Mäkinen had been handed over the keys to the brand new Evo 3 from Mitsubishi, and he and his team were super confident that they will dominate this year's WRC championship. Even Colin McRae and his team from Subaru were very adamant that Subaru's team will win this year in the 1996 WRC championship, but they had no idea what was coming from Mitsubishi. The 1996 Group A Rally Championship got you to the edge of your seat while biting your nails hard, because both drivers were so aggressive and wanted to win the cup so badly that they had the most heated of races, and the head-to-head racing and everything was just insane and crazy to watch.
We'll see the sprint time in a moment. There'll be different times though. There's Colin into the mud going around that hairpin bend there. Colin McRae 46 seconds. Tommi Mäkinen 49 seconds. 3 seconds between them.
When it all got over, Tommi Mäkinen from Mitsubishi had won the 1996 Rally Championship for Mitsubishi. And Colin McRae from Subaru had come in second. And thereon after, for the next 3 years, Tommi Mäkinen absolutely dominated the Group A Rally Championship, and with Colin McRae coming in second in 96 and 95. Both the drivers and the cars are iconic when it comes to rallying, and when it comes to the fame and popularity that Mitsubishi and Subaru got with the Impreza and the Lancer Evo, I mean, Fast and Furious, video games and everything have of course contributed a huge role into their fame and fortune, but when it comes to just straight up pedigree and heritage and racing, Colin McRae and Tommi Mäkinen were up there in the 1990s for Mitsubishi and Subaru. Both companies and cars and drivers, all of them are celebrated by fans all over the world.
One corner to go. Who's it to be to win the very first World Championship Rally Sprint in Britain here at Silverstone? McRae on the inside is going to take it. Well, there you see.
Thank you so much for watching. Check out our Instagram, check out our website as well, because we keep on posting brand new and the freshest and juiciest articles over there. Of course, because of COVID-19, please do not get out of your houses. And if you really love your car, start it every day, because I mean, you don't want the battery to dry out. But of course, stay at home and just get out for emergencies. Please do not get out of your home and increase the infection. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.